Welcome back to our minor league pregame show as we move closer to the start of Eastern League action with tonight's installment of the Bowman Prospect Spotlight. His dudeness, Dirtbag, will be our focus. Coming off a last game in which he was really outstanding in the clutch moments, collecting a whole bucket full of RBI, so he'll be looking to emulate that type of performance here again in this one.
Yeah, and you said it, Matt. He was clutch. And you know, some guys just have that uncanny ability to come through when it really matters. In baseball, it's usually when there are runners in scoring position, and he found himself up in that situation a number of times. It was pretty special to watch him out there, so I'm excited to see what he does to back it up.
All right, pregame festivities are wrapping up. It's time for baseball, and we'll have it for you next. The show's continuing coverage of Eastern League Baseball is on the air. Tonight, the finale of this four-game set. And let's also get a brief look at our two starting pitchers as you see how they stack up right there. Felipe Viña will get his first shot at it here. Fastball swung on and grounded out towards second. And taken in out there for the first out. So the rookie passes his first test here on the mound. And with that, here's how the Bay Sox align it up defensively. It's brought to us by Majestic. If it happens in baseball, it happens in Majestic. Now a swing and an easy ground ball to first. And he'll take it onto the bag himself. Two gone now here in the first. Tommy Starr will get his first cuts here with two gone now and a runner at first. Now a swing and a ground ball, and he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. His dudeness, Dirtbag, will stand in, and look at that average. Up over 370 to start the ball game. Here's the first offering. Oh, and a hearty cut there to begin the at-bat. It's nothing in one. Gets the fastball by him here, and he's in control 0-2.
And if he swung at that first one, no reason not to go up there again.
Getting a few steps off a second there. Now the pitch. Reaches down and hits this one on the ground to short. In time to first, and there are two away.
We showed you his numbers a minute ago. It's still early in the season to be worrying too much, but he's definitely off to a slow start, so he's going to need to string together a few good outings to lower that ERA a little bit.
On the ground, softly towards second. Throw to first will be in time, and there's one gone here to start the second. Carl Glenn will step in here to start their half of the third with the top of the order to follow. Fastball swung on and hit on the ground at third. Throw to first in time, and the leadoff man is gone to start the third. His dudeness, Dirtbag, will stand in. He grounded out his first time.
His dudeness, Dirtbag.
Now here's a ball hit hard on the ground to second, and that's through for a base hit. And that hitting streak of his continues to grow as it's reached an even dozen ball games now. Henry Arrudia will stand in, an RBI single in his first appearance. First pitch is a circle change for a called strike one. And he'll look at a fastball just off the black, and it's even at one. And he gives this a pretty good ride that time, but that's going to be up amongst the crowd, a foul ball. And a step off. Runner's off for second. A tag, and he's out as he can't get back in time. Tommy Starr will stand in now to get us going here in the fourth. A late swing here as this is hit hard to the right side. And he'll take this to the bag, three unassisted for the first out. His dudeness, Dirtbag, will step in now with three home in the inning and another two men out there on base.
This inning's really starting to unravel quickly from a defensive point of view. This is where you need a nice pop-up in a big way.
Now this is driven out to deep right center. This could be trouble. And trouble it is. It's down for extra bases. And the throw in gets away from him. And the second run will score as well as they've opened it up to 6-0 now.
Well, this guy's been swinging a hot bat here in the series, so you can't call this unexpected. Just absolutely rakes this ball, and he's going to drive in two more on the double.
Henry Arrudio stands in for the third time now as he takes a look at a ball. It's 1-0. I think that man right there is reaching the end of his wits.
Oh, his team is absolutely imploding right now, and it basically came out of nowhere.
Fastball at 96 on the radar gun, and it's 1-1. Oh, and he dialed that one down and got him to swing through it. It's 1-2 now.
It's just so hard to sit curveball when the pitch before is 90.
And this is low, but it's roped in quickly, and that runner will hold at second base. The tag, and they'll get him at second, and with that... Avery McMillan will step forward now to lead things off, and after that last half inning, his guys are going to have some work to do.
Yeah, and those five-run innings are tough to bounce back from, but there's still time. They don't need to panic. They just need to focus on getting a few guys on base here.
And the fifth inning will start with a ground out, one away. His dudeness, Dirtbag, will step in now and see what he can do with two on and two out here in the sixth. And this is low, but I don't think the runners will be able to move much here. Out in front of a curveball here as this is bounced on the ground to third. And the two-out threat will not come to pass as the inning is... Avery McMillan will lead it off here in the top of inning number seven. Now here's a ground ball that'll get by the mound and into center field for a leadoff single.
The batter, third baseman,
Teddy Morales will try it again. He's grounded out and struck out in two trips. Now a late square, and this is popped up. And he'll lunge forward to take this ball in the air, so quick instincts there will foil the bunt attempt. Tommy Starr will stand in to lead off the inning. Middle third of the lineup, 4, 5, and 6, as they try to get something going.
And this whole lineup's been pretty quiet all game long. Just the one run, that's it.
Oh, and he can't come up with it.
Well, in most cases, once he kicks this thing, it's going to be a sure error. But luckily for him, he's got a diesel tanker headed down the first baseline. So he's able to gather this thing up and still get the out at first.
And this is on the ground to short. Could be two. On the first, it's a double play as their woes continue. Well, you always hope to get a good outing from your starting pitcher, but this man went above and beyond in this one. He's our Topps player of the game.
Yeah, just the one run allowed, but anytime you can give your bullpen a day off.
Like them.
And now, your Harrisburg.
His dudeness, Dirtbag, will stand in, and you see there, he's been scorching hot these past few games.
His dudeness, Dirtbag.
Now a slider is lined toward the gap in left center, and that's going to be down for extra bases. Around first, heading for second now. And he will pull into second with a two-out double. Henry Arrudia will get his first shot at it here, and he's got to be hoping to turn things around because you see the numbers over the last five games. Not much going on there at all. A splitter, but he started it too low as it bounces up to the plate.
And in the first inning, with this guy already looking a little shaky, I think you let him throw you one here. He hasn't proven to me that he can find the strike zone here.
And here's a ball hit in the air. Soria has got it, and the side is retired. Mario Jimenez will get his first opportunity now, and as you can see, he enters play with that average up near the 320 mark. Now a slider is swung on and grounded towards short. In time to first, and there are two away. His dudeness, Dirtbag, will stand in here. He doubled his first time around.
Dirtbag.
Now a fastball on the inside corner, and he takes a look at strike one. Here's a fastball that crowds him a bit, and it's one and one. Two out here and a runner at second. Getting a few steps off a second there, now the pitch. And this is fouled back and out of play. And a fastball swung on and missed, and the side is retired. So it's no runs on a hit, no errors. Drew Hernandez will get his first shot here. Two hits in five trips a night ago. Hit on the ground towards first. And he'll take this to the bag himself, and there are two away now. Mark Baker, see what he can do here with two on and two out here in inning number five. Hit on the ground to shortstop. And an underhanded throw is in time for out number three. His dudeness, Dirtbag, will stand in to lead off the inning. Middle third of the lineup, 4, 5, and 6 as they try to get something going.
And this whole lineup's been pretty quiet all game long. Just the one run, that's it.
And that'll get down for a base hit.
And at this point, I don't think you could expect anything less than a two-hit ball game from this guy. I mean, he's been as hot as anybody lately, and he comes through again here.
Now a ball hit fouled off to the right and up into the crowd. Yeah, we see a lefty and a right-hander start to loosen up in the bullpen. Ground ball to second. This could be two. To second for one. On to first, and the throw's wide, but a super effort to lay out and keep his foot on the corner of the bag, and it's a double play. Vince Gonzalez will step in. He's lined out and grounded out in two trips. And maybe an excuse-me swing there as this is tapped in front of the mound. And this is knocked down on the mound. Mario Jimenez will stand in again. A couple of groundouts for him on the ledger in his two trips so far. That's on the ground to short. This should end the inning. And indeed it will. He throws him out at first, and the side is... His dudeness, Dirtbag, will step in with a full house out there in what may be the pivotal at-bat of this game. Swing and a ball line down in the left field corner. But this is going to get foul.
Hey, nice occasion. It's a pitch.
One good fastball deserves another as he jumps ahead 0-2 now.
I think he saw stars in his eyes there. He was thinking grand slam on that one.
Fouled straight back. And he reaches for one but can't find it as he's down on strikes for the final. Justin Blanchard will stand in. A strikeout victim his first time and then a base hit last time around. Now a swing and a ball grounded to second. Oh, and he can't come up with it.
One thing you're taught as an infielder, you've got to go play the ball. Don't let the ball play you. Here, you can see this ball gets in on him a little bit and he kind of just stabs at it and it winds up kicking right off the heel of his glove.
Devin Roche will get another crack, 1-for-3 thus far. Now this is hit not all that hard out to second. And indeed, he won't try to force it at second. He'll just flip on to first for the sure out. Two very well-pitched games thus far. There you see it. Each team with a one and a whole lot of zeros. 1-1 our score at this point in the ballgame. Things have been tight throughout. Vince Gonzalez will step in now in a big spot here in a game as close as this one.
A chance at redemption too, because he hasn't done much through his first three plate appearances, but he could make up for all of that with a base hit right here.
Mario Jimenez will dig in, needing to find a way to get that go-ahead run in from second base, and this will be swung on and bounced on the ground to second. On to first, and this will remain a tie ball game as the Willie Moran is set to go now as we lead off the bottom of the ninth. And this is swung on and bounced to shortstop. Throw on to first in time, one away. Matthew Avery will stand in now, hitless to this point, but with a chance to be a hero here.
Well, he knows better than anybody in that lineup that one swing could make up for a whole game's worth of struggles.
And the two-out threat will not come to pass as the inning is over. His dudeness dirtbag will lead it off here in the top of inning number 10. First pitch to him. A ball hit hard to the left side. And that's a base hit. So a little first pitch swing in there as he's on to kick off the inning.
Boy, how much hotter is he going to get? He's got himself another three-hit ball game, and that batting average is going to continue to climb even higher.
Henry Arrudia will try and erase his 0-for-4 in the ball game. Here's the first pitch. Trying to jam him with the first pitch slider, but it's in a bit too tight for ball one. A look at the hit totals there into extra innings. Inside corner, a ball and a strike. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. From the stretch. And he fires a fastball now for a called strike two. And two now.
Yeah, and that's not the pitch you want to throw on 2-2. I mean, that was so high, he didn't even have to think about swinging at it.
Fastball called, strike three, and there's the first out of the inning. Jose Diaz will stride in, grounded out his last time through. swing and a ball hit to the left side, and this is going to wind up a souvenir. Oh, he had him fooled there. No balls and two strikes.
And he's always so tough on left-handed hitters. That slider is just so difficult to pick up.
And he'll take the fastball here inside off the plate. It's 1-2.
Well, I think that fastball is just for show there. He's not trying to throw this for a strike.
And he lays off the fastball away, so it's 2-2 now. Possible go-ahead runs on first, one away. And that one never threatened the zone. It's gone full now to 3-2.
Now the question, do you send the guy on 3-2 with one out? You figure you're going to get something around the plate.
And he'll fight just to stay alive here as this is fouled away. Fastball, strike three called as he couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away. Albert Lowry will step in, 1-for-4 in the ballgame. In there, 0-1. Big swing and a miss at the fastball, and he's behind in the count 0-2.
And that's almost a carbon copy of that last fastball, and he buried both of those pitches right on the inside corner.
Now his slider in the dirt. Good block by the catcher there. And he swings on top and sends it on the ground out to second. Oh, and this goes right past him. But the recovery throw will be in time to first. Good job that time of not giving up on the play. Mark Baker will lead it off now in the home half of inning number 10. And this pitch is swung on and hit routinely on the ground to second. And the catch is made, one away. Devin Roach will step in, a ground out victim his last time. On the ground is short. Throw gets him, two down. Vince Gonzalez will stride in, grounded out his last time through. Now he'll try to bunt his way on, but this is popped up. Bravo is there to make the catch, and that means we've got more. Mario Jimenez will get us going now in the home half of the 11th. And the payoff pitch is reached for and sent on the ground to third. And the throw to first is in time, one gone. His dudeness, Dirtbag, will try again, working on a good ball game, 3-for-5 thus far. And he popped him up, back into foul territory behind first, and that's going to land foul. The 0-1. And boy, big problems here to start this at-bat. It's 0-2 now.
Oh, and you can tell by these first couple swings, he's not just looking to poke one through the right side of the infield. He's looking to put something into orbit.
Struck him out as his woes continue, as that's his third strikeout of the game. Time to hand out Topps Player of the Game honors for this one. And guys, I think we can all agree that this fellow right here deserves it more than anybody that took the field in this one.
Grab your shotgun, cock it back, shoot the sun until the sky is black. Now I sure hope that the sun got rhythm, cause he gon' dance when that music hit him. Like bang, 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 darkness fall, in the nighttime I'm camouflaged. Now I,